So please welcome Maran Balog to the stage.
Hi everyone. I'm glad to see so many diverse voices here. I'm very honored and happy to be part of this event, being part of wonderful discussions. But from where I belong, democracy, freedom of expressions, even though human rights are fantasized words, because that we discussed in political discussions, because in Balochistan, the basic right to live is snatched by the security forces of our own state that used to abduct people and detain them for decades without any legal proceedings. My name is Maran Baloch. I'm a rights activist and a survivor of enforced disappearances. I lead a peaceful movement mostly comprised of young women against enforced disappearances in Pakistan, Balochistan. I am from the southwestern province of Balochistan. I come from a region where we live like slaves of the ancient era. Even in the 21st century, our painful stories might seem like the plots of novels based on World War I, II and Holocaust. You might find these stories hard to believe, but I assure you, the Baloch community endures an unimaginable harsh existence. You live in countries where human rights are highly valued. For you, the forced disappearances of a person based on just their identity would be shocking. Yet in Balochistan, thousands of people have been forcibly disappeared, and this continues daily. Hundreds of tortured bodies have been recovered, while many who are released from secret torture cells after days, months or years bears the scale. Scars of severe physical and mental torture. Many suffer from psychological stress, mental health issues, or lifelong physical disabilities. It may be shocking to you, but there are people in Balochistan who have been forcibly disappeared for 20 years. Enforced disappearances is not only cruelty and injustices to the person taken, but it is also mental trauma for their protesting families. Families spend days and nights, and even though years, mourning their loved ones and protesting on the streets, often carrying their pictures. And it's hard and it's very painful. They carry the same picture while they walk through the hospital corridors where they found the mutilated bodies of their loved ones. I'm a victim and I ask for you, for your full attention as I narrate the painful story of my personal life, because thousands of those victims who are in Balochistan, their stories can't be heard. They don't have access to these international communities. So today I'm speaking from behalf of them. And I, as a victim, I say that my story is less painful because I'm alive, I'm still alive to narrate and witness this story. But there are thousands of families where no one is left behind to witness their stories, that what happened to them. My father, Abdul Ghaffar Lango, was a political activist who raised his voice for the fundamental rights of our people. He was forcibly disappeared in 2006 when I was only 13 years old. As the eldest among my siblings, I felt a profound responsibility. My father was the sole breadwinner and we were left in confusion and despair, praying for a safe return. My younger siblings and I protested daily, and all of my school leaves were because of the protests. I protested daily after school demanding the safe release of our father. After 2 years of relentless struggle, he was released, but he had endured extreme physical and mental torture. He was once again abducted in 2009, and in 2011, we found his bullet-riddled, mutilated body from a far-flung area of Balochistan. I still remember the day when his body was brought home. On July 1st, 2011, our life was shattered when we received the mutilated body of our beloved father. The lives of my 5 sisters and only brother changed completely. We mourned by his side And from that day, our lives have been filled with fear and sorrow. This cruelty and abuse did not end there. In 2018, my only brother, Nasser Baloch, who was also the witness of enforced disappearance of my father, was also forcibly disappeared by the security forces. In front of me, I am the witness of his enforced disappearances. I resumed my protest and after 3 months, and it was the time when I was studying, doing a medical graduation, and I got failed first time in my medical career because I was so mentally tortured, I didn't have the, you know, courage to take a phone call. So, okay, someone will call me and say that, yes, we found the dead body of your brother also. I resumed my protest, but yes, it's a relief that after 3 months of relentless effort, he was released. I resolved that I would not remain silent. That was the time when everything changed in my life. People like those who are born in democracies, for them activism may be an option, but for us, it's not an option. We are not born in regions like we have to choose, like having our personal life, having a career. We have to choose activism because there is no chance for our survival if we didn't choose activism. Last year in November, after the Pakistani counter-terrorism police kidnapped a young man and killed him in custody, thousands of us marched more than 1600 kilometers from Balochistan to Pakistan's capital, Islamabad. What we demanded? We demanded to investigate how a person in the custody of Pakistan has been killed. Rather than addressing our demand, the state ignored us. When we arrived in Islamabad on a cold December, the police bat in charge, just 290 of us were arrested, including myself. I was kept in a male police station for 24 hours, and a police officer threatened to cut my tongue. After the Islamabad High Court intervened, we were released, but an organized and sophisticated campaign was launched against us, with the media supporting the state narrative. We were called foreign agents and terrorist sympathizers. If I were to be detained, the human rights situation in Balochistan, I would need to speak day and night, and still the story of human rights violation would not end. In short, Balochistan is currently one of the large world's regions for human rights violation, yet the reality remains hidden from the world. I urge all of you to raise your voices against the atrocities happening to us. Your one voice can save our lives. Today I am constantly threatened because I struggle for human rights. Every activity of mine is watched, as a doctor, as a postgraduate in surgery. During the training in the hospital, I am followed and intimated. Despite this, I will not give up my fight for human rights, nor will I be silenced by fear. I will continue to fight for a better life for my people. When we speak about missing persons, the state uses different tactics to undermine our cause. Back in Balochistan, the media has bombarded us about questions that why people are being killed in Balochistan. And not, we are not spared even in this international platforms. On May 24, even on Norwegian soil in Oslo, at a Pan Norway event, I was confronted with the same questions. The state is backing a huge social media campaign against me, with my pictures being shared online. In one picture, a glass filled with juice is seen, and it is being propagated as wine. Another picture of my watch is being shared, claiming it cost $41,000. Here in this hall, agents of Pakistani intelligence agency have been sitting and filming me. I informed the organizers and the police. They are actively following these peoples, and they have been identified. But Norway, being an ally of Pakistan and an advocate of human rights, has a responsibility to not only speak about human rights abuses in Pakistan, but also to wake up to how to openly people backed by the Pakistani embassy in Oslo are looming here, filming and taking my pictures. They are a threat to Norwegian democracy and sovereignty. No matter how much the state of Pakistan harass me, propagates propaganda against me and undermines my peaceful struggle. I will preserve. The more they will suppress me, the more I will resist. And I will continue my struggle until the last missing person is released. Until all of my people back in Balochistan know they are all of the human rights. We want to live. We don't want to survive. And it may be difficult. And it's difficult for me also. Because my family is very afraid when I return back to Pakistan. What they can do? Yes, they can do anything. They can kill me even in there in Norway. As they have done to many of the descendants of Baloch human rights activists in exile. But they cannot silence us. I know. As well as there is a history of suppression, there is a history of resistance also. My place would be taken by my people who are enduring this pain. And I know that we have to believe in the human struggle, in the evolution of humanity. There is suppression, but there are so many good people, and we will resist every form of suppression. Thank you for listening to me. Thank you very much. Thank you.